Hi, so today we're going to be going over how to interact with a contract using Etherjs. So first off, we're going to have to install Ethers, the package. So what we can do is first install it with Node Package Manager or whatever you want. And we have a script. First thing we're going to do is import Ethers. And then have our main function. We're going to want it to be asynchronous because we're going to be interacting through the internet. So there are basically three components: a provider, a signer or a wallet, and a contract. So first let's get our provider. This will be the RPC network. And you can also do this with you can do it with MetaMask as well, I think. So first we need our provider's a URL. So we can get that from here. We're going to be using the testnet. Then we're going to have a wallet or a signer. So you can create a wallet with Ethers random wallet generation, or you can do you can put your own private key in here. And then you want to connect it to the provider. Now our contract, the one that you just made or the one that we're going to interact with. So it has an address and we're going to put it in here. So add a variable just to save it. And there's something called an ABI, which helps others understand how to interact with your contract. So we can get that right now. It'll probably be at the bottom of the contract page. And I'm just gonna curl it into here. And we're going to import it. So if you look at the ABI, there's a status, a message, and a result. And the result is the only part that we want. And now we can initialize our contract object. So this takes three parameters in the constructor: an address, an ABI, and a signer, which will be our wallet. Then now we can start interacting with it. So we're going to do something, well, rather basic for this one, and that is to check the balance of a specific address, like the holder of this token. And we just get it here. Just check the balance of its own address. And since this is going to be interacting through the internet, you're going to want to put a weight. Then and balance is actually of type big number from the Ethers library, and it has, so it's basically for numbers that are too large for JavaScript's own number type, and we can't convert it back to number because that's too big, right? So we'll just convert to string with its own built-in method. I believe it's toString. And we can run it with node and then the script name. And we can see that the contract has, well, this many tokens at its address, which is, yes, 2000 tokens. And if you want to interact with it in a way that causes a transaction, as in you're putting something that needs to be inside a block, it's going to cost you gas. So for example, these would be things like transfer, mint, or burn. These will cost you gas. And you need to have gas inside of your wallet to be able to do, well, these three or anything else that causes a transaction. And if you need gas to do so, you can go to a faucet where you put in your address and you get funded. And this also exists for other smart chains as well.